Hey everyone, Lucamus Prime here. So it is time for another franchise ranking today, and today I'm going to be ranking all six movies of The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit. So there's three movies per, you know, of this trilogy, so three for Lord of the Rings and three for The Hobbit. And believe me guys, this was quite a hard ranking to do because I love all three of these movies, I really do. I do have problems with them, but it was really hard to rank them. But then again, one does not simply rank The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit movies. starting with my all-time favourite Lord of the Rings film, which I absolutely love, and, well, this is my favourite out of all six films, it is Return of the King from 2003. And I give that a 100%, like, immediate, without a doubt, 10 out of 10. I just absolutely love this movie. It's one of my favourite movies of all time. So what I like about this, every performance of this movie was absolutely phenomenal. Really was. The action sequences were absolutely breathtaking, such as the final battle at the Black Gate. I loved it. And also the Battle of the Pelennor Fields, which was also really good too. The music by Howard Shore was absolutely beautiful. I loved how we introduced us to Denethor at last, which was really great. I also if you're wondering which version I like, I like the version which doesn't have, like, Saruman's death in it, because it makes him more accurate to the book, because he doesn't die at Isengard, he dies, like, much later on, after the events of the Return of the King. So, yeah. So, I'm glad the movie didn't include his death in, like, the theatrical version. I also, as well, loved the runtime of 3 hours. It was worth it. 3 hours was absolutely worth it. It was really great, and, yeah. My second favourite would be The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey from 2012, which I also give a 10 out of 10. And this is like a movie I absolutely adore. It's such a beautiful movie. The acting, especially from newcomers such as Martin Freeman as Bilbo Baggins and Richard Armitage as Thorin Oakenshield was great. I loved how we got to see several familiar Lord of the Rings characters in it, such as obviously Gandalf and Bilbo, alongside them also Elrond, Galadriel, Saruman, and also Frodo as well in the prologue too, which was pretty nice to see. I love how Howard Shore returned to compose the music, and once again, he delivered such amazing, chilling music. It was amazing. And the visuals also, like, slightly improved compared to the Lord of the Rings trilogy, because it was later in the years of technology. The action was also great too, such as the fight against the trolls, the opening sequence where Erebor gets attacked, and then the fight against the orcs too, as well, and the goblins. I also love how they included a nice little foreshadowing to Lord of the Rings by including the Necromancer, who would have, of course, later would be revealed to be Sauron. And yeah, the introducing new characters, like, I loved all the dwarves. They were such great characters, and the whole chemistry was also amazing as well. So yeah, my third favourite would be The Fellowship of the Ring, the first Lord of the Rings film from 2001, which I also give a 10 out of 10 to. Once again, the acting was absolutely phenomenal by the whole cast. The visuals were also really stunning too. The music was beautiful once again, and the costumes were also really amazing, and the makeup and prosthetics were also great too. And the fight scenes, oh, I love the fight scenes, so epic. And if you ask me if I have any problems with this movie, I kind of wish that Gollum had more screen time compared to what we got of him, but I can kind of let that slide a bit really, because we were saving him for the next film, which I'm okay with. My fourth favourite would be The Two Towers, the sequel to this. And I give this movie an 8 out of 10. What I like of this one, I love, once again, the whole acting by the whole cast, but I've got to give an honourable mention to Andy Serkis as Gollum. Like, oh wow, Andy Serkis is my favourite motion capture actor, and it was his role as Gollum that made him my favourite motion capture actor. He was so great as Gollum in this movie. But the whole cast was great, as well as him. I love the action sequences. My favourite being the Battle of Helm's Deep. Oh, that was so epic. I love the Battle of Helm's Deep. Music was once again beautiful. I also like how Saruman the White got to play, like, a much bigger role compared to the Fellowship of the Ring, really. I liked that. I also liked as well how they introduced new characters such as King Theoden, which was also a great addition too. And also the Uruk-hai as well, you know, the new breed of orc, which was also pretty cool. We saw a glimpse of him in Fellowship of the Ring. We got to see him in action in this movie, which was also great. Now, if you ask me what problems I have with this, I didn't like the lack of screen time for Gandalf, Arwen, or Galadriel, or or Elrond. With Elrond, I can understand them because Hugo Weaving was filming the Matrix sequels during production of this movie, so I can understand why Elrond isn't in this movie much. I also wish they didn't cut the scene with Denethor and also with Boromir too. Like, I feel like they would have added something better to the film, which is why I prefer the extended edition of the Two Towers more than this. But nonetheless, I do love this movie. It really is amazing. And my fifth favourite would be The Desolation of Smaug, released in 2013. And I give that a 7.5 out of 10. So what do I like about this movie? Acting was once again great, such as from, you know, Ian McKellen as Gandalf, definitely. And also Martin Freeman as Bilbo once again. And all the dwarf actors were also great. And I do like the addition of Tauriel, played by Evangeline Lilly. She was great as well. And I definitely also love Luke Evans as Barbara Borman as well. He was another great addition. But I did absolutely 100% love Smaug. Like, oh my god, Benedict Cumberbatch absolutely was perfect as him. And like, the entire sequence with Smaug in this film was breathtaking. So amazing. And of course, I've also got to praise Benedict for also playing Sauron too. Well, the Necromancer and Sauron, yeah. He was great in this movie, and like, the wait for this movie was definitely worth it to see him as Smaug, definitely. And, of course, I did also love the return of Legolas too, played by Orlando Bloom once again. I was very happy that Legolas came back. He's not in the book, but it was great to see him, because obviously the Woodland Realm of Elves are a part of the book, so it would make sense that he's in it, because he's part of that realm. I like how his dad, Thranduil, got to play a bigger role too, compared to Unexpected Journey, because he only appeared in a flashback, didn't he, where he left the dwarves behind Erebor. I was glad to see Thranduil making, you know, more screen time. And the action sequences, such as the barrel and river chase, that was pretty good and also pretty funny too as well. I did love that. I did love the fight between Gandalf and Sauron too, which was great. And I did like as well how the fight between Smaug, Bilbo and the dwarves, that was also great. I like as well how, compared to the Two Towers, Ian McKellen had more screen time as Gandalf, which was something I was happy about. And the cliffhanger was also great too. Now, I was disappointed the movie ended with a cliffhanger, but it left me hungry for more, which left me excited for the next film. I was also happy to see Bree again. That was definitely one of my favourite locations from the Lord of the Rings trilogy. I was happy to see it come back in this film. And I also... this was definitely a good movie. I really enjoyed it. Now, problem with this, I did not like once again how Galadriel only appeared in one scene when she appears as a vision to Gandalf. I wish I had more screen time. I also thought Bjorn was a very interesting character, you know, the skin changer, but I wish he had more screen time. I think he deserved way more. I also don't understand why Elrond and Saruman weren't in this movie either, which would be disappointing. I wanted to see more of them after seeing Unexpected Journey. I wanted to see more of Elrond and Saruman. And I don't blame Stephen Fry for this, but I did not like the Master of Lake Town or his assistant Alfred. I'm not blaming the actors, but oh god, they were so cringeworthy. Like, I do prefer the extended edition of this compared to the original version we got in the cinemas. But the scene where it shows Master of Lake Town eating, ugh, disgusting. But another great thing about the extended edition is I do like how Gandalf encounters Thrain at Dol Guldur. I did like that addition, but unfortunately Thrain got killed by Sauron, sadly, which was a bit of a shame, but nonetheless it was great. Now we get down to my least favourite franchise, but I don't hate this movie. It is The Battle of the Five Armies, the final instalment of the Hobbit trilogy, released in 2014. So I was definitely excited with this movie, and it kind of paid off a little bit, but I did have some problems with this movie. So, what I like about it. Now, the acting was great once again, you know. The best acting was definitely from Martin Freeman as Bilbo, Ian McKellen as Gandalf, Richard Armitage as Thorin. And also, I did also like, once again, I did like the addition of Billy Connolly as Ironfoot. He was actually pretty funny, too. And, of course, I did also love Manu Bennett as Azog. You know, Azog was great in all these movies. The Pale Orc, he was such a great addition, Azog. Really good. And the action was also great too, for what it was worth, such as the attack on Lake Town by Smaug. The fight at Dol Guldur that was also epic and really amazing. Get to see Elrond and Saruman and Galadriel fighting the nine men, you know, the wraiths, which was really amazing, and also the Witch King too. And then Galadriel's fight with Saruman was also really epic too. How she used the Light of Erendil against him and banished him to Mordor. Like, oh wow, that was so amazing. I loved it. The battle itself, as depicted in the title movie, was also great too. And the fight between Thorin and Azog was also great too. I did like that. Now, with regards as well, I mean, once again, just like in all movies, Howard Shore's music was also great. I also, as well, did also like how this movie was also pretty satisfying conclusion too, how it set up Lord of the Rings. I did love that ending of a movie where we shot all Bilbo, and of course, rest in peace, Ian Holm, you'll be missed. But yeah, it was so great how it set up Lord of the Rings like that. It's like the ending of this movie makes you want to rewatch Lord of the Rings again, and it actually really does make you want to rewatch it. So, now, problems with the movie. Now, because I loved Smaug so much in Desolation of Smaug, I kind of wish. I didn't like how he was barely in this movie. He only appears at the start of the movie attacking Lake Town, and he gets killed by Bard with a black arrow. Like, I wish we got more screen time, but luckily I think he has more in the extended edition in the attack on Lake Town, which is good. I also wish that besides Gandalf, the White Council members had more screen time, besides Balador Gordor. Like, I want to see more of them. Like, when Saruman said, you know, leave Sauron to me, like, I was thinking, you know, maybe we'd see more of him in the movie, but unfortunately we didn't, and I don't think Sir Christopher Lee filmed more scenes as part of that movie, did he? I'm not sure, besides the attack on Dol Guldur against the Ringwraiths and Sauron. But of course, you know, rest in peace, Sir Christopher Lee. I also wish that Sauron had more screen time, but then again, though, this is a movie, you know, not really about Sauron, it's about, you know, the enemies of the main company of dwarves, isn't it, really? So yeah. I also wish that Radagast had more screen time as well, compared to the other movies. I think he deserved way more screen time. And also, so did Bjorn as well, because Bjorn only appears as like a cameo during the battle when recruits come. Like, you know, when reinforcements arrive who have been recruited. Like, I wish he had more screen time besides jumping down like that. Like, I felt this movie was a little bit rushed. Like, this is actually the shortest film in the series, actually, believe it or not, guys. But I don't hate it. I love all six of these movies. Like, if you want to watch a bad Hobbit movie, watch the 1977 version, because that movie is so bad. I really hate it. And I give it a 6.5 out of 10. So, guys, this is me doing my ranking of the Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit movies. So, you know the drill, guys. Be sure to give this video a like. Also, be sure to let us know in the comments how you guys would rank these movies. If you've seen them, I'd love to see how you'd rank them. Also, be sure to subscribe to my channel for videos coming in the future, and I will see you all later.